dominate the work field.
According to a 2014 diagram by TeamView Talent Development, women are better educated than men. In an article by Christian Burns et al. In 2017, females are the breadwinners in 40% of homes. Catalyst.org in 2016 showed that females make up 1/4 of the STEM field occupations. So what does all this mean? That we have a problem. Are we making progress? Sure. But little progress does not deny the need for action. Women have been placed below men in the workplace since the dawn of time. And the reason behind this? Well, when it comes down to qualifications, there is none. As a woman who is also in the minority of this country, I've had a lot of firsthand experience with this gender divide in the workplace already. I've also been conducting research for the past month on the current state of women in the workplace, along with their progress to increase their presence. Throughout the duration of my speech, you'll understand what the problem is, what we can do about this global problem, and what you all can do as individuals. To begin, I want to introduce you to the problem. Women have been made to be inferior to men. According to the National Center for Education Statistics, in 2016, women received more degrees than men. And to break it down further, Black women received the most degrees out of any demographic. However, the problem lies in the fact that not even 15% of executive positions are held by women. According to a shocking statistic by Warner in 2014, women make up almost 17% of Fortune 500 companies. Now, that sounds fine, but that has been the case for almost 8 years as of the date of the article. Another, along those same lines, the percentage of women on US corporate boards is between 12.1 and 12.3%, and that has been the same for over a decade. There are so many problems with the current system of employment. Women are made to feel inferior and are second choice employees. The work field is dominated by men, for men. While a woman may be strong and independent through her daily activities, she's made to feel inferior and a second-rate employee that has to work 5 or even 10 times as hard as her male counterpart for the same benefits. I conducted an analysis of 20 Clemson University students in which I asked them to rate themselves on a scale of 1 to 10 on how confident they feel getting a job in 2017 with their personal skill set. The 7 men gave ratings between a 7 and a 9 with mode at 8. The women, however, rated themselves from a 3 to a 9, with modes at 4 and 7. Women are subconsciously rating themselves significantly lower than men. This is the confidence gap that exists between men and women in the workplace, as examined by Kay and Shipman in 2014. Women are more likely to experience the imposter syndrome, which is the feeling that they are simply faking their way to the top, or that they're just imposters. There are so many myths being spread and accepted throughout the world about women and their capabilities. Women's innate nature to be more emotional than men has been used to discredit them in the workplace. A common myth is that women are too hormonal, especially during that time of the month, to make large rational decisions. I conducted a phone interview with OBGYN Dr. Drayton in 2017, in which she said, yes, women do PMS and are very hormonal during that time. However, men produce new hormones each and every day. Under the rationale of that myth, men are too hormonal every day. Statements like this were constantly thrown towards Hillary Clinton during the 2016 presidential elections, although she had most likely already experienced menopause and is most likely not experiencing PMS at almost the age of 70. If we continue to let these myths, stigmas, and feelings of inferiority continue, we should never expect to see any sort of real equality. So now I've harped on the problem and what it means for us currently. So now what do we do about this dilemma? Men can use their voices to create larger spaces for women. Men currently control the majority of business and work affairs, and it's important for them to recognize that women are just as, if not more, qualified for the same job opportunities. that just because this hierarchy exists does not mean that we need to stick with it. We can educate ourselves, make ourselves known, and not feel inferior in order to combat this divide. In preparation for my speech, I did some research on the qualifications for a job of high standards. In this search, I found on the U.S. Office of Personnel Management website qualifications such as education, experience, cultural and political awareness, problem solving, conflict management, and more of what you may expect. None of these qualifications said gender. If we can recognize that gender is not a qualification, we need to be able to show the rest of the world that. Also, to help alleviate this divide, we can participate in mentorship programs. It has been shown by Ellis et al. In 2013 that women who participate in mentorship programs have become more successful than they most likely would have been without those programs. So now once we have people actually regarding their judgment on qualifications instead of gender, we can expect to see a future where kids don't have to struggle and fear that they won't get a job simply because of their gender. I plan to have kids, I'm sure some of you do too, if not kids, then young kids around you, but I hope that my kids or even my grandkids only know about this problem through research and history books. It should shock them that John Walker wrote an article in 2014 that contained a 2013 study that said 43% of the respondents of that study were not ready to have women leaders in their company. That should be unbelievable to them. We say we're making progress, but think about this. Women are projected to receive equal pay by the year 2059. Now, I know that sounds daunting, but let me also put that into perspective for you. By that point in time, I will be 60 years old. If we don't make any changes, we will only be perpetuating this cycle. And as shown in previous statistics, we're already showing complacency in our progress. In conclusion, now you can see that women are just as qualified as men for any work or business opportunities that come their way. Men and women both play an important role in this plan of action to increase equality. Men can recognize that women are not lesser than them and that they can create more spaces for them. In order for them to increase female involvement, they can do things such as volunteer for mentorship programs to help build up their counterparts. Additionally, women can build themselves up by taking the initiative to receive help and seek help wherever they need, so that we can ignite future and current success. If we don't take leaps and bounds, if no one ever makes this change, who's going to do it? As college students, we're entering the workforce and in turn becoming a part of these statistics. And if you're already in the workforce, you are a part of these statistics. So I want to ask you this. As we move forward,